what we think of as a flute nowadays. So it's an instrument that has a substantial amount of music written for it, and they had some very virtuosic players back in the Renaissance and afterwards. So if you think of it just as a teaching instrument, we hope to change your mind with the next tune, which is a dance tune from, well, it's from Europe, it's from Germany, and it's called a courant, which is kind of a skipping dance. Seven times over again, and nobody wants to hear the same thing every time. So musicians started coming up with variations, and you were really judged on your skill as a musician, not by only by how well you played, but by how well you could make up music on the spot. So it really has an improvisation heritage going on there.
We're going to do a similar thing with this next tune. This is the song Green Sleeves, which became very the first time it's written down is right around 1580, and it became quite popular. Different words were set to it over the years, and it shows up in a lot of music from the Renaissance and later. So maybe one of the most well-known Western musical pieces from Western civilization. So I'm going to sing some of the verses, but Rob is going to kind of improvise on the tune in between.
Thank you.
dulcimers are depicted in the Renaissance similar to this size. The ones that people play these days in folk music tend to be at least twice as large as that one. But maybe this one was used in the Renaissance because it was more portable, something of that size. As you saw with the guitar, which was also quite a bit smaller, maybe expense also was a factor.
So this little dulcimer is just big enough for Renaissance music, and in fact it has maybe a few more strings on it than we see in paintings of instruments in the Renaissance, but it's very close to what they had back then. And the hammer dulcimer is really sort of a poor manual piano. The piano has lots of strings stretched across a box inside, and when you press a key, a hammer hits the strings. Here you hold the hammers in your hand and you hit the strings yourself. This one is designed to be played either on a table or sitting down. You just put it in your lap and you can play.
Rob's going to play one time through this next song. This song is called Spagnoletta, and then I'll come in and play a little harmony the second time through.
Thank you.
And you saw at the beginning of the program, those of you that were here, the fife. So that's one of the smaller sizes of flute, but we've gotten, thought you'd like to hear that too. So just, I think, once through this tune called The Silver Swan, which is kind of one of the Renaissance chestnuts along with Green Sleeves. It's right up there with for the madrigal singers. So we'll play, actually I'll tell you what the words of the song are. We're not singing it, but The Silver Swan, who living had no note, when death approached, unlocked her silent throat. Leaning her breast against the reedy shore, thus sang her first and last, and sang no more. Farewell all joys, O death, come close mine eyes. More geese than swans now live, more fools than wise. So the silent swan only makes a sound, this is the legend anyway, when it's about to die. So it doesn't say anything, it doesn't have to, as opposed to the goose who just chatters all the time.
It was called, at least we have the German name for it, is Rauschpfeife. So Rausch is loud and noisy, and Pfeife is a pipe. So this is a loud pipe.
So these are also loud, as Rob said. And the reason they're loud is because it's flared. It's a conical bore, as opposed to the Krummhorn, which is just a straight bore. And so this lets out more sound. So again, we'll see if we'll kind of face away from you here a little bit, maybe.
Of course, we have
ears to, goes down.
Have to make a couple of toots here. Yep. A bit like a geese, it's goose itself.
Yes, right. It was a good one to follow up the swan song. Which is the straw fiddle. And the reason it's called this is because the bars of wood were typically placed on straw to act as a little resonator. And players could go around the countryside with a bag of sticks, basically, and lay them out on a pile of straw.
Or just put them on the carpet.
On the carpet.
Which they didn't have so much back then.
Not so much carpet. So Rob's arranged this in a box so that it's easier to transport and keep together. And it's instead of having it on straw, resting on straw, he's got some little ropes underneath there that at the nodes that resonate with that. So we've got a whole suite of tunes here for you to hear. It's the early version of the xylophone.
Or a wooden hammered dulcimer.
Wooden hammered dulcimer. So the straw fiddle, straw fiddle.
Actually play tones, but you don't change the tones ever, and that's why they're drones. So that's okay. There we are. Yeah. So you've got three strings on it, and you tune them to three different pitches, and you just keep them there. But the drumming part comes in that you've got a stick, and you hammer on those strings as you would, and make rhythms as you would on a drum.
By the player with another instrument, because as you see, you've got one hand doing the drumming and then you've got a hand free. So this is a three-hole pipe or a tabor pipe. It's got a one-handed flute, sometimes it's called. Mm-hmm. So it's created so that you can overblow, like a trumpet that has three valves. you can rearrange your fingers and blow a little harder and get full scale out of it, so you get a full tune that way.
So with one set of fingerings, I can go. And so on, and by combining those, here too, I can. So this is the three-hole pipe, and you can play simple tunes on it, and you can accompany yourself drum-like either with the string drum or any other kind of drum for that matter.
So the instrument that I'm going to play that has a drone is this instrument known as the hurdy-gurdy, and that also has strings in it, but it's inside the box. Two of the strings are drones, so they don't change pitches as you play, and the way that you play is that you turn the crank, and instead of having a violin bow, this wheel rubs against the strings and makes the sound. And then one of the strings, so it has three strings, two of which are drones, the other one you can change the pitch by touching these keys that have a little mechanical tangent that touches the string. So instead of having your fingers on the strings, like most stringed instruments, you play this way. So some people refer to it as a string bagpipe because it kind of has that sound. But we need some more percussion on this, I think. And so we've got a frame drum that appears all over the world. Every continent has a frame drum. And we need somebody to play that. Over here first, and then we've got stuff for you. And then we've got a tambourine that has, it's a similar to a frame drum, but it's got little jingles on it. Play that one. And let's see, we've got some bones. So we've got these are made out of wood. They're played typically in one hand like this, to clack like that, but that takes a little doing, so to learn that, so. And just tap them together. Did you want to do that? We need somebody to play bells, which is just like this. There you go. And we need somebody to play spoons, because if you went to an outdoor fair, you might just bring along whatever you had at hand to make music with. So again, you could play these on your leg, or you can tap them together. And I think that's all. We just have more of the same. So does anybody else want to try bones or anything else? Okay. I guess we've got the front row mostly covered. All right, so this is a song. We give you the rhythm for the song. Oh, I've got my monkey here, my sock monkey. The hurdy-gurdy of this sort, there's the stringed hurdy-gurdy, and then again that name was reused for a barrel organ, like in the late 1800s. And so the barrel organ player would crank, and it was kind of like a mechanical thing that just, like a player piano, but it just played the tune. And then sometimes that barrel organ player would have a little monkey that would go around with his tin cup and collect tips from the people. That's why the monkey's here, but it's not the same instrument played. So we're going to all play together. Can you show them the rhythm to do? Whatever sounds good to you, you can play.
Oh,
those things. We're going to finish up with one more tune. Put those in here. Okay, good. Thank you. Well, I guess we're using the tambourine for this one. So this is where we're going to go into Renaissance Festival mode, and we need to put our hats on.
There was a, of course, we're supposed to be in character, we're supposed to be people living 400 years ago, and with all the sort of superstitions and things that go along with life 400 years ago. So we finish our show this way, and we say, good people, you see before you not ordinary tablespoons, nay, they be magical spoons given to me by a wizard who said if I ever gathered a group of people together and they were to clap when I hit the spoons with the stick, the weather would improve. Do you believe a word of that?
No.
Nay.
If I told you that on this very stage, gotta remember we're pretending in it, on this very stage, last weekend, why, storm clouds gathered in the distance, thunder and lightning were heard, and I quickly gathered a group of people together, and they clapped when I struck spoons with stick, and the weather cleared up. Would you believe a word of that?
Nay.
No? Would you believe this is just another trick by a couple of entertainers to get you to participate in another tune?
Yay! Yay!
Good wife, tell them how this works.
I shall tell them how it works. As you see, good Robin here is playing the tambourine with a stick. And he's shaking spoons in his hand thus. We want you to clap once each time all together when he strikes the spoons with the stick thus. I shall demonstrate. There. Would you like to try that? There you go.
Ha! That's the part of this. For in my village of Rooster, where I come from, yes, I come from the village of Rooster, I'm known as a tricky fellow, and I shall try to make you clap where you're not supposed to clap. So you must keep your guy close upon me.
So when Robin is playing the tambourine with a stick, don't clap there. And when he's playing the spoons in his hand, shaking them, don't clap then. Just once each time he strikes the spoons with a stick. Shall we have a slow motion?
Slow motion. Yes,
all right. I shall play upon the fife.
You shall.
All right. You ready?
Yes.
You think?
I am.
Ready? You sure? Are they ready?
Making sure.
All right.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Tim.